Hey guys, thanks for joining me for this week's Faith Life. In Luke chapter 24, verses 5 and 6, an angel says, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen." A couple of the ladies had decided that morning that they wanted to go and put aloes and ointments on the body of Jesus. But when they arrived, they found out that his body wasn't there. The tomb was empty. The rock had been rolled away. They could see that no one was inside. And an angel spoke to them and said, "You came looking for someone that was dead. He's not here. Why do you look for the living among the dead? He's not here. He's risen." You know what we see encapsulated in that brief moment? That those that followed Jesus thought he was dead. Pastor Brad, what does that have to do with anything? It's not the deepest thought in the world. When somebody's executed, of course you're going to think that they're dead. Well said. Let me say this. There is such a movement within our world to say that the followers of Jesus deceive the world by setting up the story of the resurrection of Christ. I want to remind you today that the disciples, the believers, the ladies that traveled with them, none of them were looking for the resurrection of Jesus. They were looking for Jesus to rule and reign on an earthly throne. They weren't expecting him to go to a cross and to die so that he could rule and reign in our lives and allow his spirit to live in us. The disciples were hidden away. They were afraid. They were timid. They were scared for their lives. They weren't duping the world. They were wondering how they were going to make it through the next week. But something changed. They went from being afraid to being powerful, from timid to being bold, from hiding away to being out in the open. And you know what it was? It was the resurrection. The resurrection of Jesus changed everything for them. And the resurrection of Jesus changed everything for us. The tombs are empty because Jesus is alive. He liberates the captive. He defeated death, hell, and the grave. And we too can go through our life with that assurance that we're not going to be defeated either. Romans 8:11 says, "If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal body through his spirit who lives in you." A simple reminder. As we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus this weekend, be so thankful that he did defeat death, hell, and the grave, that the tomb is empty and that he's alive, but also recognize the responsibility that because he lives in us, we carry his resurrection power everywhere we go. And in Jesus' name, we too can raise the dead and set the captive free. God bless you. And enjoy living in the resurrection power of your faith life.